Army Corps and the navigation interests were kind of at loggerheads with environmentalists and conservationists.
You had state agencies suing federal agencies and just a lot of strife, right?
And the judge basically said, okay, you guys got to work together to figure this out.
It took a lot of people along the river writing letters, postcards, and sending telegrams to their congresspeople in Washington to say, hey, we need to do something on the Mississippi River.
The navigation interests really wanted to do some work on the river. They wanted to expand locks and dams. And the environmentalists said, no, we can't do that. They were at loggerheads for 15 years. So finally, in 1986, through the WRRR program, they arrived at a deal.
The language of the 1986 Water Resources Development Act did was it said, no, there's a better way to think about this. And the way to think about this is the river is an internationally important natural resource. And it is also a nationally important commercial navigation system. So in statutory language, it was kind of the message of knock it off.
So that was a forced partnership. But it evolved into a more friendly working relationship over the years. It's not only the Army Corps and the states, but Fish and Wildlife Service and all the other states as well.
It wasn't just a signal, it wasn't just a message. It put money and it put authority behind that. What's really important about the UMRR is it pushes both agencies out of their policy and programmatic silos, and it pulls individuals out of their disciplinary silos. And it creates that space and that need for them to work together across those boundaries.
The public, the states, the federal agencies have all agreed, and it's rare that you can get that many folks in a room to agree on things, that this is an important resource. This is not just a nationally significant resource, it's a globally significant resource.
It's a commercial navigation corridor, and it's an internationally important migratory flyway and really unique riverine resource. And so bringing that understanding to people so that they can appreciate the need for that balance management is really central, and I think it's a big part of what the UMRR has allowed the agencies to do.
The agencies have worked to really refine how they do that. And they've gone through a series of changes in how they build islands and how they work with backwaters, and it's really amazing to see the progress that's been made.
Fundamentally and foundationally, the biggest success is actually the way the UMRR has served to allow agencies that, frankly, in the 1970s were really at odds with one another about how the river should be managed, to come together and to work both productively and proactively on that balanced, integrated management.
The partnership is the reason why we're here. It's the reason why we're successful, and I think it's going to be the thing that drives us into the future and continues to result in successful restoration along the Upper Mississippi River system.
When everyone works together as a partnership, we have this.